Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, of course the campaign for the 2023 presidential election is already in full bloom. There's absolutely no question about that. And to that end guys, I bring you this: APC crisis will quarantine Oshiomhole's enemies. So this is now Tinubu making political maneuverings yet again. So again, the headline: APC crisis, we will quarantine Oshiomhole's enemies. So this is now a comment attributed to Tinubu backing Adams Oshiomhole. So now let's now see what the GBT1 of Lagos State has to say. Barely 24 hours to the meeting of the National Executive Committee of the All Progressive Congress APC to decide the fate of its ousted national chairman, Comrade Adams Oshiomhole, former Lagos State Governor and national leader of the party, Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, has finally taken a position on the crisis. In a statement he personally signed and made available to newsmen at the weekend entitled 2023, A Different Form of Ailment, Tinubu, who has since declared interest in the 2023 presidential race, attributed the leadership tussle rocking the APC to desperation for 2023 presidential ticket. In a statement he personally signed and made available to newsmen at the weekend entitled 2023, A Different Form of Ailment, Tinubu, who has since declared interest in the 2023 presidential race, attributed the leadership tussle rocking the APC to desperation for 2023 presidential ticket, accusing presidential aspirants of infecting the party with what he called 2023 virus. The former Lagos State governor faulted the agitation for the removal of the axed national chairman of the party, accusing those behind it of ingratitude. Tinubu, who admitted that the cold war between the APC national chairman Comrade Oshiomhole and the Edo State governor Godwin Obaseki was a potential threat to peace in the party and its electoral fortunes in the forthcoming governorship election in Edo State, however, claimed that the aggrieved have not explored crisis resolution mechanisms in the party. He said, "The more a person obsesses over and constantly engages in political maneuvering is a warning sign. Not only is he prone to the 2023 virus, he likely has little to offer in the way of good governance. He wants to hold public office that you might serve him, not him serve you. For if he had adequately studied and be acquainted with the ways and means of progressive governance, he would be focused on the important task at the present moment. He certainly would not drown himself and all around him in harmful political intrigue." So now let's not say exactly what the So now let's now see what the GBT1 of Lagos State has to say. "However, the party has moved through proper procedures within the proper organs of the party to hopefully resolve this part. All party members know this. Such decisions are part and parcel of internal political governance. Yet, motivated by ambitions that have nothing to do with the quality of the chairman's performance, people shunned the agreed party reconciliation mechanisms and resorted to other means to oust him. These self-help attempts are unwarranted. These attempts reveal more about the malafides or malafides of their perpetrators than they do about the chairman. on the emergence of the Deputy National Secretary Victor Geodom as acting National Secretary, Tinubu further alleged that Geodom was being used to destroy the party by certain forces he claimed wanted to hijack the party structures and organs ahead of 2023. The plotters launched their attacks solely because they perceived the chairman as an obstacle to their 2023 ambitions. People went to court knowing full well the party constitution prohibits such actions because these people had not yet exhausted all internal disciplinary procedures. We even had a national deputy secretary improperly call for a neck meeting on the basis that he believed himself the acting national chairman. Clearly, this man would not have summoned the temerity to make such a move had he not been instigated by powerful individuals who he thought would reward or at least protect him for committing the wrongful act. Those engaged in these maneuvers see themselves as clever or cunning. They do so because they only understand the mean craft of political intrigue. They have yet to understand the value and long-term utility of democratic governance. Thus, they embark on the strangest quest. They would rather dismantle and weaken the institutional core of their party just to gain control of that weakened edifice. He said, in a broader context, those afflicted with the 2023 virus do a grave disservice to President Buhari and his administration. They should be trying their best to help the president instead of seeing President Buhari as our present leader and commander-in-chief. Their sole contemplation is upon his eventual exit. Yet, not even a full year has passed since his second inauguration. How can they be committed to helping him realize his mandate when the fullness of their gaze is affixed to seizing this very mandate for themselves? The president is faced with many challenges. He is fighting hard on security to keep the population safe. He is pushing for economic reforms that will augur future sustainable growth. His disdain for corruption remains unwavering. Add to it now the corona crisis and its resultant social and economic impact. Politicians express loyalty to him, but the words of too many of our politicians are like butter under a burning sun. They melt away quickly. Better to be loyal indeed, instead of trying to manipulate party and other mechanisms solely to their political gain. It is time to shelve political intrigues for the time being. It is time to shelve political intrigues for the time being. It is time for all party members to truly see what is at stake and work with Mr. President for the collective good of the nation. This means we must rally around Mr. President Buhari instead of everyone saying they are working for the party and the nation, but going their separate ways based on their selfish designs. We must help him build a stronger national consensus on policies that will ensure safety and bring a greater prosperity. If need be, and when called upon, we must offer ideas and suggestions that move policy and progress forward. This is the time for governance. It is not the moment to bring the politics of 2023 into 2020. In due course, 2023 shall come. Nothing can prevent it. However, that time is not today. If we are earnest, the present offers sufficient work and challenges for us without trying to add to it by rushing to the future. Let us dedicate our energy to helping President Buhari win the present. In this way, you better secure the future for the nation, the party, and even for whatever personal ambitions you nurture. So it goes on and on. Let me just read the last paragraph because I think we're now coming to that now. Tinubu added that, "I have said what is only on my mind in the hope that some people may leave 2023 frenzy and commit themselves to the harder yet more rewarding task of improving progressive governance, whether within the party or at the local, state or federal level. Yet, I am not naive to think all will heed this counsel. The stubborn, those obsessed with the obsession of their ambitions, will ignore all advice. They will constantly pull 2023 into all that occurs in 2020. Their vision is blurred and judgment made faulty by their ailment. We are Democrats, so we cannot physically quarantine them. However, we can quarantine their ideas and antics by not falling prey to them. This is the best way we help President Buhari fulfill his mandate and inoculate our party and the nation from grave folly. So this is a campaign speech, if ever there was one, because this is a guy, of course, this Tinubu character that is saying, oh, leave 2023 alone. And he then went on to make a full-blown campaign speech, because have no doubt about it, this is a full-blown campaign speech. One, he's back in the show, Mole, and is using the weight of his presence to ensure that, at least to try and ensure that Adams Oshiomhole stays in position. So if he does succeed in ensuring that Adams Oshiomhole stays in position, then Adams Oshiomhole, of course, then out of gratitude is going to back him. But Adams Oshiomhole will back him anyway. But also now, if he saves Adams Oshiomhole's job, Adams Oshiomhole then, of course, will back him come 2023. So that's the game that he's playing. He's also playing the game of a unifying figure as a father of all, as a leader that, look, I am rallying all these people to tell them to calm down and sheave their swords before 2023, so that Malam Buhari can focus on governance for that period. So this is another language that is speaking, because he's speaking, of course, the language of a leader, the language of a unifier, and the language of somebody that has a presidential aura. So this is another thing that he's doing. So all of everything and its entirety of what he said is a party political speech and a campaign speech. So this is a man that is already in the full-blown campaign mode. And what is he using as the topic of that campaign? Telling his other competitors to sheave their swords. I mean, imagine the stupidity. Only the really foolish, but of course he's not really speaking to, let's be fair, he's not really speaking to his rivals anyway, because his rivals already know that this is just a nonsense that he's saying. But he's speaking to the more gullible, who will see him that, oh, it's Ashiwaju speaking, our leader is trying to rally everybody. This guy will make a good president too. He wants us to focus on good governance first. 2023 is so far away now. Why are all these people rushing now? Ashiwaju is right now. So he's putting himself in that bracket as a leader, a unifier, a presidential hopeful, and somebody that carries that aura and that presence and that soundness of mind and that public pronouncement that we would expect of a president. So a full-blown campaign, of course, by this Tinubu character. But then, of course, how is El-Rufai? And now we're putting, by the way, Sanusi in the mix as well. So by the way, that guy, the PDP guy, the one that lives in Dubai, whatever his name is, Atiku also is not giving up yet, because he will want to go down the Buhari route and say, okay, if Buhari can contest a million times before he became president, I will contest him. So he's speaking to all of his rivals, of course, but none of them pay heed. Are you paying heed? Come tell me what you are making of this public pronouncement by this GBT1 of Lagos State called Tinubu in the comment section. But before you do that, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. Bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come tell me what you're making of what Tinubu has to say in the comment section. So I'll leave you here. Carry this conversation on with you in the comment section. But here, I say, peace.